Now, this may well surprise you. Until the release of the Signia Silk Charge&Go IX, the only rechargeable hearing aids on the market either looked like this, which is the ReSound Omnia, or this, which is the Phonak Lumity Receiver and Canal Hearing Aid. So annoyingly, if you wanted a more invisible option, then the only technology available used a disposable battery. And this needs changing roughly once a week. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the good news is that this is all about to change, as Signia have just released the world's first rechargeable CIC hearing aids. Introducing the Signia Charge&Go IX. Now, rechargeability is one of the many unique features built into this incredibly small new technology from Signia. And today I'll take a deep dive into exactly what those features are, if this technology is suitable for you, and also the three things that I think are missing from these hearing aids. And then you can decide if you can do without them. Released in September 2023, the Signia Silk IX has superseded the Signia Silk X, which is now 3 years old and long overdue an update. Today, I'll first of all fill you in on the physical side of things and show you how they look in my ears, and then we'll take a good look at how clever the technology is that's working inside these hearing aids. This new family of hearing aids doesn't look any different in shape and size to the previous model, and I'm honestly amazed that they've been able to make this new rechargeable version with exactly the same physical specifications of the battery version, and for the battery to perform as well as it does. So the only difference that you'll spot between the two of them is that there's no longer an openable battery door on the rechargeable version. For those of you unfamiliar with the Signia Silks, they're shaped in this torpedo way and ergonomically designed to mirror the shape of an average ear canal, measuring 15mm long, 10mm tall, and only 4mm in diameter. Quite differently to other CIC hearing aids, these are ready-to-wear devices, and therefore they don't require an impression to be taken of your ear by your audiologist. Instead, they have a semi-customizable design with interchangeable domes for the end to suit the shape and size of your individual ear canal. And to be honest, the dome selection isn't something that you need to worry about, as your audiologist would measure and select the most appropriate fitting for your anatomy and your hearing loss, with plenty of options to choose from. I've mentioned before in a few videos that the tip on the end of a hearing aid isn't solely designed for comfort. It actually plays an incredibly important role in the way that a hearing aid sounds, influencing factors such as the hearing aid's clarity, its ability to cope in background noise, and it also has an impact on the way that your own voice sounds. And therefore, it's incredibly important to get the correct setup for you. The devices themselves come with two different colors to choose from, with the bodies of the shell always being either red or blue for easy identification for which is the left or the right. But the outward-facing part, the faceplate, being available in either a mocha or a black matted surface. From my experience in clinic, the majority of patients prefer the black colour as it looks like the shadow of the ear canal and just makes them that little bit more inconspicuous than trying to match your skin tone. Back to rechargeability now, a single 3-hour charge will give you 24 hours of life. So each charge will last you for a full day. The case itself is neat and pocket-sized, and rather impressively given the size of it, has a built-in battery which provides you with an additional 3 days' worth of charge before it needs charging again. So if you happen to go away for a long weekend somewhere and power wasn't easily accessible, so for example, a camping trip for 3 days, then all you need is the case and you can charge on the go. As these hearing aids are the gift that keep on giving, in another world first, the case itself has Qi charging. Qi charging? Qi charging? Qi? Qi? I don't know. Which essentially means that you don't need to plug it in to charge it, but instead can place it on a wireless charging pad for inductive charging. Or, if you're old school like me and you can't pronounce that word, you can still use the USB-C port on the back of the case. So that pretty much covers all there is to know about the physical side of the silks. So I'll go into a little bit of detail now on this new world of technology that Signia have built into these hearing aids. As with all hearing aids, the Signia Silk IX isn't suitable for all degrees of hearing loss. However, it does have a pretty broad fitting range, meaning that it's designed for those with a mild to moderate sensory neural hearing loss. And in my opinion, could be pushed to compensate for those with a severe hearing loss in some of those higher frequencies. In practical terms, that means that if your hearing loss falls within the shaded area on this image, then technically they could be suitable for you. They're available in three different technology levels, the 7iX, 5iX, and 3iX, with the former being the most advanced of the three. The more advanced the hearing aid, the greater the number of features and automation that you have access to, which you can see the details of in this table just here. So diving into the details on this new iX chip, it runs all of the same features as the Silk's predecessor, the X chip. However, with a few key developments, starting with Signia's Dynamic Soundscape Processing 3.0. This feature integrates various processes within the iX chip for hearing aid optimization based on your surrounding environment. Analyzing 192,000 data points per second relating to your specific situation, and then deciding on the most appropriate way for this hearing aid to react. This feature, combined with Signia's ear-to-ear wireless 4.0 and then their binaural one-mic directionality, means that these hearing aids are working together rather than as two individual units, which is quite unique to Signia, in fact, for their in-ear hearing aids. This is beneficial for two different reasons. So firstly, identifying the direction of those speaking to you and focusing the microphones in the correct position. And then secondly, employing their speech stabilizer feature, which targets speech in a noisy environment, and that can be a few different situations, such as a restaurant, car, or walking down a busy street, and then preserving the acoustic cues that are important for you to be able to follow and understand speech clarity and distinction. Another feature unique to the Signia Silks is their wireless functionality. Now, hold on, before you get carried away and jump into the comments and tell me that wireless features aren't unique to Signia, you are 100% correct. However, it is certainly a unique feature for hearing aids of this size and discretion. From your point of view, this gives you access to the Signia app and the mini pocket remote control to make basic adjustments to the settings and also to access their tinnitus features, which is a nice segue when it comes to tinnitus management. Signia offer three different strategies against tinnitus depending on what's the most appropriate for you. Static noise therapy, ocean wave therapy, and Signia's unique tinnitus notch therapy. Both the static noise and ocean wave therapies are different types of noise to mask your tinnitus, all with different characteristics, different frequency responses, and with some of them being more likely to be effective than others to have a positive impact on drowning out your tinnitus. And then finally, Signia hearing aids also uniquely utilize a tinnitus strategy called tinnitus notch therapy, which is specifically designed for those experiencing a tonal tinnitus, such as ringing, buzzing, or whistling. This approach is quite different to using a masking sound, and Signia claim that the concept behind notch therapy isn't to drown out tinnitus, but to teach the brain how to ignore it completely. Unlike both the ocean wave and static noise sound therapies, this method is presented at an inaudible level, so you won't even be aware of the tinnitus sound therapy that you're being exposed to. It's pretty clever. CROS or BICROS systems are designed for those of you watching with an unaidable hearing loss in one ear, i.e. no hearing at all, and either normal hearing or a hearing loss that requires a hearing aid in the other. A CROS system is essentially a transmitter that detects any sound that arrives on the poorer hearing side, and then it wirelessly transmits the sound to your better hearing ear, giving you access to the world of sound in 360 degrees. For example, if you're sat on a bus with your unaidable ear towards a friend, a CROS system would transmit their voice to a hearing aid in the better hearing ear, allowing you to be able to hear them clearly and comfortably. The Silk wins another point here for not only being the only CIC CROS system that's out there, but also the world's first rechargeable CIC CROS hearing aid. Now, I have shared a lot of positives today, but this video wouldn't be a balanced review if I didn't also give you a thorough understanding on what's missing from the Signia Silks. And as I mentioned at the beginning of this video, there are three features that you'll get with other hearing aids that you don't get with the Signia Silk iXs, that are without question worth considering before you go ahead and buy them. So let's start with how they function in background noise. Signia utilize their one mic directionality technology and the pinner effect, which is this part of the ear that gathers sound from in front and behind and determines what's in front of you versus what's behind you. Despite this, the Silks won't cope as well as a receivering canal behind the ear hearing aid, which has multiple microphones built into it so that it can help you identify whether you're in background noise or not and the direction that sounds will be coming from. If background noise is one of your biggest challenges, then without question, as I do with any of my patients, I would recommend looking at the Pure Charge&Go iX, which is the behind the ear model, which I've covered in this video and I'd recommend watching after today's video. Secondly, yes, the Signia Silks do have wireless connectivity, but no, they don't have Bluetooth built into them. So the discretion of the Silk iX does come at a cost. And again, if you're interested in streaming phone calls or media such as the radio, music or podcasts to your hearing aids directly from your phone, then the pure Charge&Go iX receiver and canal version may be more appropriate for you. And then the third thing that you definitely need to consider when looking at these hearing aids is that whilst it is a positive to be able to customize these hearing aids by changing the tips on the end, rather than going through the entire process of having an impression taken of your ear, as you would do with a conventional set of CIC hearing aids, at the same time, this also does mean, in reality, that they don't fit quite as well as a custom-made set of hearing aids. This is definitely not an issue for the majority of ears. However, there are instances that we, as audiologists, may want to have things made in a very specific way. So, for example, with venting to allow your ears to breathe and to prevent what we call the occlusion effect. And we don't have that same degree of control as we would do with a hearing aid specifically tailored to the shape and size of your ear canals. There is no question that if you're watching this as an audiologist, you should consider adding the Signia Silk iX to your portfolio. And if you're somebody with a hearing loss and you're conscious of cosmetics, then it may well be worth considering them too. The thing is, they also may not be the correct aids for you. So I would recommend without question checking out this video for a range of Signia's other hearing aids, and that'll help you really understand which may well be the most appropriate hearing aids for you out there. And then make sure you subscribe by pressing this circle just here. And I'll see you in the next video.